Hi, hello, welcome back everyone. Today it is our new lesson. The topic is let's learn about the files and folders. Some of you might know about the files and folders. So what is a file or what is a folder? Now today we are going to learn about these things, because you know, right, in this chapter we learned about the operating system and the work done by the operating system, and from there we got to know that the operating system manages the files and folders, right? So now today we are learning about the files and folders, some information about the files and folders, right? So there are two people talking together. A boy is telling, I think this is his mother or something, or his sister maybe. So there are a lot of different types of files in a computer, aren't there? We learned, right, that there are different types of computer. In computer, there are different types of files. You learned it in grade 6. Okay. Yes, you can group them and store in folders. So these different kinds of files, if you don't know what is the meaning of files, you can go to our YouTube channel and watch the grade 6 classes. There you will learn about the files. So files can be in different types. For an example, it can be a video, it can be an audio, it can be a document, it can be a PowerPoint, it can be a picture, whatever. These are files. These files, we can group them and store them in a folder. So what are folders here? right. So this is a type of file. This is a type of file and this is a folder. What is a file? A file is anything that is saved in the computer, such as a letter, a song, a photo. A file has two parts. One, the file name, another one is the file extension. For an example, I will show you. So see here, these are files and folders. Here there are files and folders. Can you see these yellow color, like butter color things? These are folders. Inside these folders, there are some files and also there are some folders, see? Inside the folders, there are some subfolders and files. Okay. Files are different types. For an example, this is an MP4 file. That means this is a video file. This is a PPTX file. That is a PowerPoint file. This is a JPG file. JPG file means it is a picture. Understood? So files are in different types. Okay, right. So as it is said, we can store files and subfolders in a folder. Files are divided into two. One, that means the name of the file. See here, for an example, we'll go with this name, sbzapp.black.mp4. So before the dot, it is the file name. After dot, it is the file extension. So what is the file name and what is the file extension? File extension means the type of the file. File name is named for the file. To search it in an easy way, we name the file, right? So as it is here, the file name used to identify the file very easily. So if you save a file, you name it, right? You give it a name. Then only you can identify the file very easily. File extension means used to indicate the application software that is used, okay, of the file. So for an example, as I told you, if it is a video, it is an MP4. If it is an audio, it is an MP3. Okay, so with the file extension, we can identify the application software of the file. This is a file named Sport Meet, created by a word processing software. So this file name is sportmeet, and this after the dot, it is the extension which is made by or which is created by a word processing software, right? Okay. Now let's learn about the folders. Now you know a file. A file is it can be whatever. Okay, a file can be saved as a letter, as a song, as a photo, or whatever it can be saved as. And a file has two parts. One part is the file name, another part is the file extension. So what is a folder? The place where files are stored is a folder. Now when you are storing files, you store them in the folders. Okay? They are used to store files that are related to each other. It helps to keep files in order and to retrieve them easily and fast. So there are main folders, and within folders we can also save subfolders. This folder is particular for the study buddy zone, right? Whatever the study buddy zone classes are conducted, all the things are inside this folder. Inside this folder, there are many folders and files. For an example, in education material, there are some past papers, there are some seminars, there are some syllabus. So inside the syllabus, all your books, okay, all your school books are saved here. See, English medium book, Sinhala medium book, and Tamil medium book. If you click the English, there are classes, see, grade 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 level. So inside grade 6, there is your PDF books. So here I am categorizing all these files to identify them very easily. Okay, I separate them in folders and then I keep them. Then when I search for these files and folders, it will be easy for me to search them. Understood? Okay. So now let's see how to create or edit folders. How to create a new folder, how to edit a new folder. For an example, first of all, you should select a place to create a new folder. Okay? Whatever the place in the computer, select the place you are comfortable with and create a folder. How to create a folder? The folders are created like this. Now, assume that I am going to create a new folder in grade 7, right? And here I am going to click create the folder. First of all, right click your mouse button, go to new and go to folder. Now new folder is created. Now give a name to this new folder. For an example, I am naming this folder as grade 7 homework. Okay, grade 7 homeworks. Now all these homeworks will be sent, all the homeworks which you are sending to me, I am going to save inside this folder, right? Now there are at about 34 students, right? So I don't know which student sent me the homework and which student who didn't send me the homework, right? So what I do here, for each student in the class, for an example, for Adam and for Safiya, for Marzu, for Zainab, for Atik, for Asia, I am creating folders for each of these students. For an example, we'll say Zainab is a folder. Then Ahmed is a folder. Again, Mohammed is another folder. So I am creating folders for each student in the class. Now, when Zainab sends me a homework, I save it inside this Zainab folder. Now it is easy for me, right? to see which student sends me the homework and which are not sending me the homeworks. Understood? Right. Okay. Now you know how to create a folder, isn't it? You should right click the mouse button, click on folder, and new folder will be created here. Fine. Okay. Next one. How to save a file or in a folder? Now we are going to save a file inside the folder. For an example, we'll say, now this is a file, right? For an example, we'll say this is a letter, for an example, right? I am sending it to someone. So now I am saving this letter. I should save it in the computer. When I save it for the first time I wrote this letter and first time I am going to save this letter, we'll go to file, save as, browse, okay? And select the place where you want to save this file. For an example, I am saving this file inside the folder grade 7. For an example, okay. Now we created a folder. We are going to that folder. So inside grade 7 homework, I am going to save this file. So I am saving the file, save. Now this file is saved in the place where I selected. Okay. Now, next one. Now I know how to create a new folder, how to save a file inside the folder. And now we are going to open the created folder. Now we'll open the created folder. First, you should go to the location where you saved the file. Okay. So I saved the file inside grade 7, as you see here, inside grade 7, grade 7 homework. And this is the file. See, it is saved, right? Now, if I double click this one, the file will be opened. Okay. Now you know how to create a new file. Sorry, how to create a new folder, how to name a folder, how to save a file in a folder, and how to open a created folder, and how to open a file. Next, copying and moving a folder. What is the meaning of copying a folder and moving a folder? Copying a folder means you are taking a copy from that and pasting in another place. So there are two copies. Moving a folder means you are cutting a folder from its place and going and pasting it in another place so that you won't find it in the first place. For an example, we'll say like this. This is my folder, right? Grade 7 homework is my new folder. Now I am copying this folder, for an example, right? I one click on the file folder, right click it, and here copy. Take a copy. We'll say we paste it here. Right click, paste. Now the folder is pasted here. So the folder is here as well as the folder is here also, isn't it? Right. No, I don't want this folder in this place. I want it only in one place. So what I do, I cut this folder. Right click the folder, cut it. Then go to the place you want and paste the folder. Paste. Okay, we'll say we'll cut this folder from here, and I am going to put it in the desktop. I am going to paste it in the desktop. So I am going to the desktop. We'll paste it here. See, grade 7 homework is pasted here. Now let's see whether it is in the place where we pasted here. It is not here, right? So we cut it from a place and paste it in another place. Now you know how to cut a folder and copy it in another place, paste it in another place, and copy from a place and paste it in another place, right? There are some shortcuts also. Without clicking the mouse click, right mouse button, and all these messes, you can use some shortcuts also. For an example, CTRL plus C means copy. I will show you how to do that. CTRL plus V means paste. CTRL plus X means cut. Write it. So this is a keyboard. Okay. In this keyboard, there are two control buttons, two control keys. Here is a one control key, and here is another control key. So when you are copying a folder, first click on the folder one time from the mouse, then click on CTRL, control, and C to copy the folder. If you are cutting the folder, control X. Okay. When you are pasting the folder, control V. With control button, control key, press V. Understood? Now how to copy, paste, and cut? Next, how to rename a folder. Now let's rename a folder. Okay. Let's rename the same folder, right? Okay. This folder. Grade 7 English homework. Click on the folder. Then right click on the folder. There is an option. Rename. Click on the rename, and now you can rename it. For an example, Sarah. I renamed it. Now see, it is renamed as Sarah. This is how you rename the folder. Files also you can rename it like this. Okay? Right. Next one. Right. So to change the name of a folder, take the mouse pointer on the folder, onto the folder, then select rename command after clicking the right button of the mouse. Step 2, type the required name and press enter. Then the folder name will be changed. Next one, delete. How to delete a folder? We can delete a folder temporarily, or we can delete a folder permanently. Okay, two types of deletions. Permanently we can delete them, or else temporarily we can delete them. So first of all, we will delete it temporarily. Okay, for an example, we'll say this file, this folder, Sarah. Okay, we are going to delete this file folder. So click on the folder, then click on right mouse button. There is a command called delete. Press on delete, and here it deleted. Where it is now? It is deleted temporarily. We can go and find it. Find it where? In the recycle bin. See, this is a recycle bin. There is a trash bin here. It is a recycle bin. See, Sarah, it is here, right? So this is how we are deleting. Or else you can use the keyboard also to delete. There is a key called delete in the keyboard. Just press the folder you want to delete and then press the button or press the key delete in the keyboard and the folder will be deleted. Understood? Not control delete, only delete. Only delete. If you want to delete it temporarily, just click on the delete. Press on the delete. Okay? Right. Now we'll see how to delete it permanently. Okay? For an example, you can delete a folder or file from the recycle bin. For an example, we'll say this one. I will show you it. Okay. For an example, we'll say this grade 7 Sinhala folder. I want to delete it permanently. So I can go and right click on it, delete. And then they will ask me a question. See, are you sure you want to permanently delete this folder? If I say yes, it is deleted permanently. Now you can't get it. Okay, this is deleting from the recycle bin. If you want to delete it permanently from the place where you save it, okay, from the place where you saved it, then click on the folder and in the keyboard with shift button, press delete. Are you sure you want to permanently delete this folder? Yes. Now it is permanently deleted. See, in recycle bin also, you can't find it. It is not in the recycle bin also. Understood? So here, how we can delete it permanently, I will show you. Here, there are two shift keys in the keyboard. Okay, you can either click this shift button or else you can click this shift button all along with this or this shift button, click on delete and permanently it will be deleted, right? So there is an important note here given to you. If you delete a folder that is in an internal location, such as in a hard disk, it is deleted temporarily. That means it can be retrieved when needed. If you delete a folder that is in an external storage device, such as a pen drive, it is permanently deleted. It cannot be retrieved again. Right? So, whatever, as I showed you, whatever the file or folder you delete it from the computer, it goes to the recycle bin. Okay, so you can recover it or you can retrieve it again. If you delete permanently also, you should know something else also. Okay, it is not to complicate you. Now we are deleting some files and folders permanently, right? Then it goes to where? It doesn't go to the recycle bin. You can't find it in the recycle bin. It means it is deleted permanently. But if needed, okay, if needed, there are some softwares, you install it to your computer and get the deleted files and folders which are permanently deleted. Again, you can retrieve them. Next. Let's identify the characteristic of a file and folder. So what is a characteristic of a file and folder? There are characteristics in a file or folder such as size, type, and date modified. Also, there are many characteristics of a folder and a file. When the mouse pointer is taken on the OK, now I will show you how to identify the characteristic of a file or folder. So here you can see a file here, right? This is a file. These are folders. Now we'll see the characteristic of this file. Right click on the file. Go to properties. And a window like this will be opened for you. See this? Now here, you can see the type of file. What is the type of the file? And in which software this file is open? Okay. Location of this file. Where is this file saved? Size of this file. Created day, date, and time of this file. Modified day, date, and time of this file. Accessed day, date, and time of this file. So see, all the history of the file is here. Now, I created this file on November 11, 2020. Okay? At 8:52 p.m. And last I accessed. Accessed mean last when I did open this file. Last I opened this file on January 23, 2021 at 7:31 p.m. Now let's see, I am going to open this file now, okay? And the modified date is also January 23, 2021, isn't it? Now I am going to open this file. Okay, let's see whether this modified and access date and time will change or not. Okay, for an example, right? Now I am going to open this file. Okay, right. Now it is opening. Here. Now we'll say I did a change here and saved it. Now I am going to close this file. So now see the time, 8:23 p.m. Right? Okay, I am closing this file. Now I am going to check the details of this file, the characteristic of this file. We'll say whether it changed or not. For an example, see here, modified date Tuesday, March 9, 2021. Changed, right, at 8:23. And last access date is today, March 9, 2021. 1 minute ago, I accessed to this file. Okay. So here, we learned the characteristic, how to check the characteristic of a file or a folder also you can check. File type, when naming a file, the method of showing the file type, file extension, and the location of the file, size of the file, and date and type created of the file, date and time modified of the file, date and time access to the file. So these are the characteristic of a file, right? And that is all in chapter 2. We are learning all this in chapter 2. Let's go. I hope you understood chapter 2. Just I am going with a small review, a summary of this operating system chapter. So here we just keep everything and listen to me. We learned about the operating system and what are the tasks performed by the operating system. For an example, I taught you that the operating system provides the user interface to the user and controls the functions of the system CPU and also manages the computer memory, controls the activity related to storage devices, and performs tasks related to processing files and folders, helps to protect the computer through username and password, and also manages the hardware. After that, we learned about the different types of operating system. I told you that there are operating systems used in the computer as well as operating systems used in the telephones or the mobile phones, the smartphones. For an example of operating systems used in the computers are Microsoft DOS, Windows, Macintosh, Apple Macintosh or Mac operating system, Ubuntu, Fedora, Linux, all these are used in the computers. Then we learned about the operating system used in mobile phones, Android, iOS or iPhone OS, BlackBerry OS, Windows Mobile OS are some of the examples. Then we learned about the computer storage devices. So what is what are computer storage devices and why we use these computer storage devices. We use these computer storage devices to store the data and information which are in the computer, right? Then we learned about the parts, or we learned the storage devices. For an example, I told you that these computer storage devices are divided into several parts according to its manufacturing technology. So three: magnetic media devices, optical media devices, and solid state media devices. So magnetic media devices, for an example, hard disk and magnetic tapes, also floppy disks, are magnetic media devices. And optical media devices, I told you that all the data and information are read and written by laser beams. That is the technology of optical media devices. And for an example, CDs, DVDs, and Blu-ray discs. Then we learned about the solid state media devices. And why we call them as solid state media devices? Because the technology, when they read and write the data from it, it doesn't have a moving parts. It doesn't have any moving parts. That's why it is called as solid state media devices. For an example, pen drive and memory card and solid state drive. Then today we learned about the files and folders. I told you that a file can be saved in several types. For an example, it can be a letter, it can be a song, it can be a photo or whatever. And then a file has two parts, the file name and the file extension. Every one of you should know these two. And then we learned about the folders, that we can save files and also subfolders within the folders. Then we created a folder. We saved a file inside the folder. We opened a created folder. We copied and we moved a folder in the computer. And then we changed name. We changed the name of a folder and deleted a folder permanently, also temporarily. Then finally, we identified the characteristics of a file and folder. So this is all we learned in chapter 2. Understood, everyone? So it took me 5 minutes to tell you the summary of this, the chapter 2. Can you do me something? It would be interesting if you can do that. Learn the chapter 1 and 2. I will send you the notes of chapter 1 and 2 today, inshallah. Okay, just drop me a message to my phone in WhatsApp. Okay, a message like grade 7 English notes. That's it. Send me a message like grade 7 English notes, and I will send you both the notes of chapter 1 and chapter 2. Okay, everyone should write the notes in your books, in your particular notebook. And then you should do a thing. Now you know, right? When I finished the chapter 1, I told you the summary within 5 minutes. And today in chapter 2, I told you the summary within 5 minutes. Okay? Take time, practice, okay? Take time and practice the chapter 1 and 2. Record it in the WhatsApp as a voice record and send it to me. Can you do that? The summary. Can you guys do that for me? Just practice. Learn the chapter 1 and 2. I will send you the notes also, but you should drop me a message because I have a hella lot of numbers. So I don't know who is in which class. That's why I am telling to you to send me a message. Learn the short note I am sending to you. Write it down in your notebook and then practice the, that means learn the subject and practice by your own. Okay. After practicing, if you can make a summary with your own, you talk, you tell what you have learned in chapter 1 within 5 minutes, send me a 5-minute short note in a voice record. Okay, and the chapter 2 also send it in a voice record. If you have any doubts in the subjects, you can go to our YouTube channel, okay, Study Buddy Zone channel. If you don't know how to go, just send me a message and I will send you the link also. And don't forget to subscribe the channel. Yes, after the class, don't forget to subscribe the channel. And then go and watch these videos and practice by your own and send me the voice notes. We'll see whether you understood the lessons or not. We finished 2 lessons, right? Very, very interesting lessons. Okay? Right. send me a message to my phone, okay? Not in chat box. Okay. If you want the link, send me a message. I will send you the link in the WhatsApp. It would be easy for you then. ICT. No, use your name because you are sending the message to me, okay? Your homework to me, send it with your name. Okay, so hope you understood the lesson today. Next week, we will learn about the security of the computer system. So I will finish the session today. So hope everyone understood the lesson and enjoyed the lesson today. Thank you for joining the class. And until we will meet again at the next class, have a nice day, everyone.